So next I need to make the neck for this ukulele, and I've got my one-to-one printout for this and the neck. I'm going to make this part first, and I've got some white oak here. This is the only white oak I've got. It's not terribly pretty, but I want to keep with white oak just to make this part the same wood as the body. So I'm ready to cut the scarf joint here, and I've got it supported from this side, not this side, because I don't want that wedge that I'm cutting off here to wedge itself between the blade and the support on this side. So here's the neck, and this is going to make part of the block here. I still need to cut that out here, and then this goes on here. That will form a scarf joint, and there's the head right there. Now I need to join this next scarf joint together, and I've got this rigged up for gluing it in here. I'm just going to wedge that in here, because if I just glued it together like that, the glue is a lubricant and it would always kind of squish it out. So I figure with this on there, and if I just ram that in there with the other clamp, I'll hopefully get a good joint surface in here. I also need to make sure this is flush on both edges, so I'm just going to put a clamp on there. So thanks to the packing tape I had against here, the glue squeeze out did not cause the neck to get glued onto here. So next I want to taper this neck just a little bit, and I'll do that on the table saw. So I want to put a slight taper on this neck, and this would have been easier if I'd done that earlier. So what I've done is I've clamped it to this block of wood, and I put a shim on this side, so this acts a bit like a taper jig, so that I can bandsaw a taper on here without doing it freehand. So what I want to do is create a flat spot on here for where I'm going to attach the neck. And to avoid tear out, I put a piece of wood underneath here, and I'll just try to shave that flat with the table saw. So next I need to cut the neck mortise in the ukulele. And a really good tool for that is the pantorouter. So I have the template for the mortise clamped in here, just kind of a scrap of plywood. And I used my clamp here to hold down the ukulele, and I made sure this block here is parallel to the edge. So now I have on here a tenon template for cutting the tenon in the end of the neck. But before I cut the one and only neck, I'm gonna cut it in a test piece just to make sure I have the fit just right. Well, it would be a good fit if it didn't have 3/4 of a millimeter of play. So I need to make another template, and I just did. And I made this part 1.5 millimeters wider than this on here. And that should make a tenon of just the right size. So I've now very carefully positioned the neck. This whole thing would have been much easier if I'd done this before I tapered and shaped this neck, but lesson learned. And I placed it at an angle to offset for the fact that my ukulele is a little bit crooked. Good fit. So I'm going to attach the neck with these hanger bolts, and they're a screw on one side, and then they're going to go through here. I'm going to put a nut on there, and to line up the holes correctly, I'm just going to put the neck in the neck mortise and put the drill of the right size into one of my holes here and just tap that with a hammer, and that will mark where I need to drill a hole in the neck. So I drilled the pilot holes for these screws on the small side because I want a lot of thread engagement. But to avoid splitting the neck, I made myself a sort of screw tap by taking one of these hanger bolts and grinding two notches into it. So now I can use this with my drill to tap out these holes. So I had a less than perfect fit with the neck, so I had to drill these out a little bit to get this to really fit on there. And so now from this side, I just put on the nuts. This is easy enough when there's no back on the instrument. But once the instrument is put together, I have to do this through the sound hole. So the tricky part will be to use a small nut driver and put the nut onto the screw. And it looks like I should be able to do that.